So large jump in view out if we go from bug to host directly. So bug post.
Okay. So this is the main reason to have a bug boost mode in between, because the bug boost region is basically more like a dead zone for bug and boost. So you cannot regulate the output in between that region because of the limited or max or min duty cycle, because your duty cycles are saturated. One is saturated on higher side, other is on the lower side. So bug and boost cannot do anything. So you have to operate in bug boost. Now let's say I go to bug boost. So V out is, I know, is debug over 1 minus deboost into VDD. What is the boundary condition? Boundary of bug 2 bug boost is debug equal to 0.9, let's say. Okay. And we already calculated what was the VDD? 3.67 volt for V out equal to 3.3 volt. So when you enter bug boost mode, what will be the deboost? Is 0.1? Correct. So what is V out here? 3 point is same as VDD. So still your output is changed. How much now you have? From 4 volt, 3.67. So there the change was 700 millivolt. Here it's roughly half of that. Okay. So, still you have a jump, but it is not as large as previous one. So, how do we fix this? So, your output will basically then jump and so this is the one case. Your other case is this. Bug to boost, and this guy is bug to boost. This is V out. Okay. So in case you will see overshoot will be more, and let's say my spec is 5% roughly, this way far from that, huh? That is, that guy is like going 700 millivolt. This is, I mean, 5% of 3.3 volt is how much? 160 millivolt roughly, huh? So in both the cases you are basically not meeting the spec, regulation spec. And if you are using, let's say, 3.3 volt devices that supply is fixed, then 4 volt like the devices may damage also. So this is undesired behavior, and we need to fix this. How can I fix this? Huh? Yeah, you reduce the debug. Okay. So what will be the condition for that? I mean, how do I know how much debug is required here? At the boundary. So, left hand side, so let us say you are at the boundary. So,
So, this is buck, this is buck boost. And for this guy, buck boost, okay.
So, V out is nothing but debug max, okay, in the bug mode. So, and V out is debug over 1 minus deboost main let me write this way. At boundary, okay, and this is at boundary. When I say boundary, you are looking at a very thin line where you are looking at a left hand side and right hand side, okay. So, you at left hand side of you have a buck and right hand side you have a buck boost, okay. So, if you are slightly lower than 0.9, then you operate in buck mode, and when you require more than 0.9 cycle, you enter buck boost mode. So, you are right at the boundary, and we want to find when we enter buck boost mode, what will be the required debug, which means both the output voltages are same, your VDD are same. So, these two, which means debug max into VDD should be equal to debug over 1 minus deboost. This is gone. So, which means debug is debug max into 1 minus deboost. This is your boundary condition for buck to buck boost. Same thing you can do for buck boost to boost, okay. So, the left hand side equation will change. In that case, basically left hand side you will be operating in buck boost and right hand side you will be operating in boost. So, in buck boost your equation will remain same, debug over 1 minus t boost, okay. In what condition you will enter the boost? When will you enter the boost? So, now let us do the same thing again. So, we know that debug max is 0.9, deboost min equal to 0.1. So, what is debug? Okay. So, now if you operate in the buck boost, you make your debug 0.81 and your deboost is 0.1, you can achieve the same voltage, which is equal to 0.9 of debug, okay. So, you won't see any overshoot in the output, it will remain at the same constant voltage. Now, after that what do you need to do? Now, let us say further my VDD is further reducing, I want to increase the duty cycle. So, which duty cycle you have to increase, deboost or debug? Hmm? you can achieve a higher voltage by increasing both, huh? Whether you increase debug or increase deboost, your output will, you can achieve basically the same output for lower voltage, lower VDD. So, which one, which makes more sense, to increase debug or deboost?
Deboost.
Why? No, but you have a 10% margin there roughly, which means 10% more current you will be burning and you will lose your efficiency. So, it does not make any sense, Yeah, so you have to increase the debug and let the debug saturate, then after that you increase deboost. That is more logical, Why do I saturate, forcefully saturate debug at 0.8 when I have debug max available up to 0.9? Okay, that's how you control actually. So you have to monitor the duty cycle and see where exactly we are, and you switch your duty cycle control. We will see how we generate this duty cycle actually. Okay, you can do a digital way or analog. So buck and boost is simple, you know how to do it, but in the buck boost you require both the duty cycles, You have only one control voltage and you have to generate both duty cycles. So, I know this is my boundary condition. When I am, my duty cycle, buck duty cycle is saturated to 0.9, if I jump directly to buck boost, I will see this kind of jump. Okay, that is clear? So, now in order to fix that, at a boundary condition, when I start my both buck and boost, I have to reduce the buck duty cycle to 0.8, correct? So, when you are operating at 0.8, buck and you start increasing the boost duty cycle, what will increase here? What will happen to the inductor current when you increase the boost duty cycle? It will start increasing, but if I fix that deboost at 0.1, I still have a 10% margin, and start increasing the debug and let it go until 0.9, my inductor current will not change, it's because you will lose efficiency, and we are doing everything for efficiency, so why do I lose efficiency unnecessary? If I can achieve 1 or 2% more, then I will do that. It's a big deal, 2% efficiency is a big deal actually. I mean, in, if you go in the market, like they compete with the 1% efficiency. If one part has a 1% more efficiency than the other, nobody will buy the other part actually, if it's giving at the same cost, same performance. If somebody can give you like 15-20 minutes more battery life in your phone, it's a big deal, And you realize that when your battery is near 0% actually, you will think, okay, if I can get 15% more, if you are sending any urgent email or anything. So, the converter is all about efficiency here, these switching converters. If you can achieve 1% more, just do it actually.